student aesthetics and actually saw it my way in this morning. I was like 1.5 kgs heavier than I was yesterday, which means I am literally back where I started, right? I did all this fat loss for nothing, all right? I spent the whole week cutting. I'm back at the same weight. So all my work was thrown away. I'm fat again. Now I'm just fucking with y'all. I'll explain that in a second because today I want to talk about tracking your progress. So let's do it. So yeah, like you saw this morning, I was weighing a lot more than I weighed yesterday. And that obviously has to do with the sushi I had last night. And I kind of explained that already in yesterday's vlog. But yeah, that has to do with a higher sodium intake and also with a higher carb intake than I had before. And that will make your body store glycogen and water, and therefore you may weigh more, right? And that doesn't necessarily mean that you are storing fat, because you can actually weigh more and still lose fat or stay at the same fat level, right? For example, you know, you drop 0.1 kg of fat, but that same day you gain 0.3 kg of water weight, you will weigh more even though you have lost fat, right? And that is the thing with body composition. It is very, very hard to track. And that is why right now I want to give you guys 3 ways of tracking your body composition, because I think it is very, very important to keep track of it. And you know, a lot of people, when they would wake up like me this morning, they would be like, oh my God, like I did everything for nothing, everything that I stand for, all this hard work is just thrown away. And that is absolutely not the case, all right? And therefore I want y'all to understand, you know, the different fluctuations that are going on in your body and how you can accurately track that in order to keep making long-term progress while not getting too caught up into thinking that everything goes wrong or just stressing too much about certain factors. So you always gotta realize that your body does not work in a linear way. Fat loss is not a linear process, just like muscle gain. So it doesn't mean that you're gonna lose like 0.1 kg of fat every single day. You may lose nothing for a week and then all of a sudden all the fat may come off, or vice versa, you may lose a little bit every single day. So the number one way of tracking would be your daily weigh-ins. This is something I have all my clients do, it's something I do myself, and then you take the weekly average, all right? Reason being is that if you weigh yourself once a week, you may just weigh yourself on a day that you have been eating high sodium the day before, for example, or you just overall have a high weigh-in, and it may not be representable for your actual weigh-in. Now, at the same time, you know, looking at daily weigh-ins is something you don't want to do that much either, because every day you will weigh differently. One day you may weigh more even though you have lost fat, like I just explained, because of those fluctuations in your body as far as glycogen and water goes, and therefore you want to take the weekly average, and that is the really the most accurate way to track your progress in the long term, and also actually in the short term as well. So when you wake up in the morning and you weigh yourself, don't always expect to hit a low weigh-in, all right? Even when you're cutting very, very deep, it is not always gonna happen. Some days you may stay the same for multiple days in a row and you'll be like, oh my God, I have to decrease my calories. But always keep in mind that you wanna wait at least 1 to 2 weeks before you make such changes through your diet. Because you may lose all the fat at once, or you may lose it like the next week, because fat loss is not a linear process, right? And therefore, you know, the daily weigh-ins are something that is very important to me. Next to that, you know, progress pictures, and you can do that daily like I'm doing right now, my mini cut, but daily is a little bit overkill in my opinion. Most people will not be able to do that or will simply forget about it and shit like that. So I recommend taking progress pictures every single week, or even twice a week would be good as well. And then make sure to always do it after you wake up in the morning, before you eat anything, all right? To give the most accurate outcome. And progress pictures are really fun to compare. And even though you will not see the visual progress every single week, or maybe even every single month, over the months you will really see the progress. And me right now with the daily weigh-ins, like, if I look at it on the daily, I will not see any progress. But right now, when I look back at 8 days ago, I see a lot of difference. So it is really fun to track it that way, even though like it takes a pretty long time to see a difference when you're cutting, obviously, way earlier than when you're bulking. So when you're bulking, I don't recommend doing it more often than once a week. You can also take progress pictures once every 2 weeks, but you don't have to do it, like you definitely don't want to do it every single day, because there's gonna be very, very limited difference. And then the third way of tracking your body composition would be simply measurements, all right? Measurements around the waist. You may also want to measure your arm size, your chest, etc. I personally don't do it. I've tried it in the past. I just noticed that I wasn't able to stick to it. And with anything as far as fitness goes, consistency is key. If you're not able to do the weigh-ins consistently, if you're not able to measure yourself consistently, then you know, it's just not going to work out. And for me, that didn't work out. So I use the 2 other tracking methods, and I feel like those 2 are enough for me personally. So if you know for yourself that it's just not going to work out, then make sure to focus deeply on the other 2. Or you may not want to take progress pictures, and then you focus on the other 2, then you do daily weigh-ins, and the waist measurements. And then you have two ways of tracking your progress as well. But I recommend having at least two ways to make sure that you're on the right path and to basically be as accurate as possible. So that is really my advice on tracking your body composition. And I feel like every single person should include these type of tracking methods into their daily routines. So definitely try it out, guys. So yeah, I'm really not worried about today's weigh-in because I know that in the next couple of days, the weight will gradually come off and I will go past my weight loss plateau and I will hit a new low weigh-in. So trust me on that, but you'll see that in a couple of days. So yeah, I already expected this, nothing to worry about. Now the cool thing is that today I weigh more, so I'm gonna fucking kill this leg day. I got squats coming up and I wanna destroy them, so that's gonna be fun. So right now it's 4 o'clock. I'm actually getting my first meal ready here. I'm gonna start off with a very small meal because I'm gonna work out between 6 and 7 today. Right now it's 4 o'clock, so that's in about 2 to 3 hours. And I'm not very hungry yet, so trying to save the carbs for before and after the workout. So what I'm doing is I'm cooking up some eggs over here. Got 3 whole eggs and 2 egg whites. And then I'm gonna add that to some high protein bread. Just gonna do one slice because one slice is 150 calories. So this is pretty calorically dense. If you are bulking, I highly recommend using this because 2 slices, 300 calories, easy gains. And in the meanwhile, while this is cooking up, gonna have 10 grams, 85% chocolate. And I'm actually rocking the shirt that I showed y'all yesterday. Perfect for a leg day. I ain't got no comma, man. This is it again, like always. I'm also gonna have some cashew nuts with that. Gonna do 25 grams. And I'm about to hit a leg day in about an hour from now. It's a bunch later. I just hit that leg workout. Afterwards, had a hippie shake. And right now, I prep me another meal because it's already pretty late. It's 9:30. What I'm having here is basically the marinated chicken that I had the other day on my full day of eating. It was the vlog that I uploaded the day after yesterday, so make sure to check that out if you haven't already. And then some veggies here with noodles. So definitely a good meal there. Pretty huge as well. And I just had, you know, a crazy amount of rice cakes. I had 30 grams of 85% chocolate just to hold me over while I was prepping this, even though I already had that hippie shake because I was so damn hungry because we hit a big leg day there. So right now I'm gonna eat this meal while I upload the footage. So I'm gotta do multiple things at the same time right now because of the daily vlogs. Y'all are keeping me busy, so I'm gonna have to like structure my time differently. I constantly have to eat while I'm editing or doing something else. And also, as far as the workout goes, I went back to my old gym because Stan is this week not training with me, as he said in my vlog yesterday. So this week I'm gonna have to train alone. So I decided to hit up a friend of mine. He trains at the old gym I used to train at. If you're an OG subscriber, you may know that gym. But yeah, I wasn't actually supposed to film in there, according to them. So I wasn't able to get really, really great shots or a lot of shots. So it's all like one shot of each exercise. Tomorrow I actually got a very fun day planned because last week I was invited by Arie Boomsma, who is like a very famous guy in the Netherlands. If you are from the Netherlands, you definitely know who he is, but a lot of my followers obviously not. So I will explain all of that tomorrow, what I'm gonna do. But he is opening a new gym in Amsterdam, so I'm about to drop down there and get kind of like a freestyle workout in as well, because I obviously hit the gym yesterday, today as well. So we're about to see what's gonna happen tomorrow. I'm not exactly sure, but it's definitely gonna be fun, another trip. So I hope to see y'all tomorrow. Make sure to hit the subscribe button to stay updated. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up as well if you liked the video, which I hope you guys did. And if so, I will see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.